Good morning, good morning, good morning. We thank God for this opportunity that God has given us this morning. My name is Pastor Ben Nganga, and I love Jesus as my personal Savior. And I want to invite all of us, wherever you are in this country, and maybe even those people who are from other countries. And I want to invite you to these broadcasts. A live broadcast, and I know God is going to bless us this morning. First of all, I will start by what I normally do. I pray, and after prayer we go live and we speak on the few things that God has given me so that I may speak to all of us here. It's what I call the prophetic word that God gave me concerning Kenya, and so I know God is going to bless us as you tune in. However, I want to pray for seven things that I normally pray for all of us. Number one, I want to pray for health. May the Lord keep you healthy, strong, because your health is your greatest wealth. And so I speak divine health upon your body in the name of Jesus. I pray that you'll be healthy, you'll be strong. I pray wherever you go and whatever you do, the grace of God to guide you, and that you may be also carry health within your body in the name of Jesus. I also pray for security. May the Lord keep you secure in whatever you're doing, wherever you are, in the mighty name of Jesus. We also pray for peace, the peace of mind, the inner peace in your life in Jesus' name. May the Lord keep you at peace. May the Lord keep you strong. May the Lord keep you healthy in your emotions, peace. And also number four, I pray for a healthy mind. May the Lord give you a healthy mind today. The Bible says, as a man thinketh, so is he. And so I pray for a healthy mind for all of us in Jesus' name. I also pray for divine wealth upon your life. The Bible says he gives you the power to gain wealth, and he delights in the prosperity of his servant. And so may you acquire whatever you need for your bills, for your investments, and everything in Jesus' name. We also pray for destiny helpers upon your life. May the Lord send the right people your way. And I want also to speak to Kenyans. It is good to know that we are ambassadors of Christ, those that are believers in God. We are ambassadors of Christ. And so our help comes from above. In times of economic problems, in the days of Elijah, God provided for him. He ate well and he lived well. And so as a country, God is going to provide for us in Jesus' name. I know there has been a lot of issues. Thank you for all that are tuning in. The Lord bless you. I know there have been so many issues about this country. Thank you, Polly. Thank you, my wife. I appreciate Patricia. Favor, the Lord bless you. Godfrey, welcome, Godfrey. Biggie Small, my brother from Nairobi, the Lord bless you, the Lord bless you. Purity, God bless you, God bless you. And many more others that are listening, wherever you are. Thank you, my wife, Patricia. I appreciate your support. God bless you so much. Many more are listening from different places of this country. And I want us to tackle on the prophetic vision that God gave me pertaining this country. And I want you to hear me clearly, because I feel the Lord speaks to his people. God is still in the business of speaking. Welcome, Alice. God bless you, Faith. I appreciate you. Tourists, and wanasema turi kule juu. Asante sana, Faith, for listening. We are coming there. We are coming to visit you soon, Faith. I believe in a God who speaks. I believe in a God who can talk to his servants. He is still in the business of speaking to us. And there is some few things that the Lord has showed me concerning this country. Thank you, Favor, Paris, Mbuvi, Mbuthia. Thank you, Polly. And Liwali, thank you. Bless you so much for tuning in. Agnes, the Lord bless you from US, the land of opportunities. God bless you so much for tuning in. Sorry for for my pronunciation. I would like to say that God is in the business of speaking to people. And there is something that the Lord spoke to me that I want to share with you today, this morning, concerning this country. And please, if you can, and you join me in prayer, because this is a vision that was so vivid, and the Lord spoke to me so vividly. And I started praying since that day. And I want to share this with all Kenyans, because I feel we need to tackle this issue spiritually. And I thank God for the men and the women of God that are praying for this country, all over this country, from Mombasa, Nairobi, Kisumu, and even Nakuru, and other cities and villages. And even outside the country, there are people who are still seeking God because of Kenya. And I thank God for the watchmen that the Lord has raised across the country and other nations, because of this land, our beautiful country, Kenya. Now, I remember the Lord showing me two visions concerning our country. And let me share these visions with you, because I feel we need to pray and we need to seek God and ask Him to help this great land. And so I believe that whatever God showed me was not to cause fear, but it was to show me what we need to pray about. The Bible says, and God said, how can I go to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah? Yet I have a friend of mine, Abraham, without letting him know. So God is letting people know what is happening in this country. Those people who are seeking Him, fasting for this country, as watchmen, as intercessors. And so God is showing us things, and we don't just pray, we pray with what God shows us. And I remember the Lord showed me, it was in the night, and it was a long vision. I was taking, sorry for the interruption, because of our internet, I'm sorry for that. But the Lord showed me a very vivid vision. I was taken up in the skies, kwenye anga ya Kenya, on the atmosphere, in the which word can I use? I was taken up and I could see Kenya from above, and I saw some people constructing a wall, a great wall, and this wall was going through forests, through cities, and through towns. And I saw some people hired to build this wall. And when I looked down, I asked myself in the vision, who are these people and what are they doing? And what is that wall for? And I remember that a voice spoke to me in the vision that this is a wall of separation. It is a wall of hatred. It is a wall of division. And so I kept on going through that wall. It was like I was in a plane or something, because I was going above the Kenyan land and through cities and the forests and the land. And I kept on seeing this wall being built, and there were people that were assigned to build it. And when I looked down, I saw it was being, the people who were giving orders for this wall to be built were politicians. And they had men, especially young men, who were building the wall. And I kept on asking, because the wall was not dried up, it was still very wet. So it was in initial stages of being built, like the way you can build a perimeter wall, or you call it a perimeter wall. And it was very, very wet. It was newly constructed. And I kept on asking, why are they doing this? And the voice that was speaking to me, and I firmly believe, because I see such visions, it is usually the voice of the Holy Spirit. And the voice was speaking to me and telling me, we need to stop the construction through prayer. We need to stop. We need to decree that the world builders will not have that ability, and we stop their building. We dispossess them from their ability to build the wall. And so as I kept on flying, it was like I was on a plane, and I could see this wall. It was very long, going through cities, going through towns, going through the rivers, going through the forest. And I kept on hearing the voice that the politicians are speaking to these people to build this wall. And I heard the voice of God speak to me in the vision that we are supposed to bring down that wall. And that is the work God has given the intercessors and the watchmen of this country. Our greatest work and in prayer, and the prayer we are supposed to be praying, is to, of course, discourage through prayer the builders. In other words, we disconnect them from the voice of the political class, and we speak against the walls of hatred. We speak against the wall of division, because that is what the Lord showed me. It is a wall of division. It is a wall of hatred. And it was still wet, so it was not strong. It was not a strong wall. And the Lord spoke to me, and in the vision, I could hear the clearly, deal with the wall. Speak to the wall that it may crumble. Speak to the wall that it may fall. Speak to the wall that it may come down. Speak to the wall that and stop the builders. Through prayer, stop the builders through prayer. And Kenyans, I want to call on all of us, as you pray, let us stop the builders, every evil builder, through words that are being spoken, builders of walls that are walls of division, of hatred. Let that wall, before it dries up and becomes a strong wall, the enemy, before he makes it a strong wall, before it becomes strong, while it is still wet, let us bring it down in the name of Jesus. And so I pray for all of us, and I pray for anyone who is a watchman, anyone who is an intercessor. Let us come against the spirit of division, the spirit of hatred. I saw that wall crisscrossing the country being built, and the people who are building it were being instructed by politicians to build the wall. And so we believe in one Kenya. We will not have a divided Kenya in the name of Jesus. And as a believer and as a pastor, I want to send you, if you are a believer in God, the Lord showed me that vision. And he showed me that there is a wall that is being built in this country. But it was still wet. It was not strong. It was still in its initial stages of being constructed. It is like a perimeter wall. And the voice of God spoke to me in that vision. Speak to this wall. Speak to this wall as it was in the days of Ezekiel. Speak to the bones. And the voice kept on speaking to me, speak to the wall that it may crumble, that it may be destroyed. And so today, this morning, I believe as believers, we come together, come against this wall that is being built but through the instructions of the politicians. They instruct the Kenyans, and we as Kenyans, we find ourselves building a wall of hatred and division. We take authority in the name of Jesus right now. We come against any wall builders in the name of Jesus. Any human vessel being used by the devil to bring hatred and division in our country, we deny them access over the people's will in the name of Jesus. We deny any anyone who is a politician their voice of hatred, or the voice of division. Any politician, all the way from the senior politicians to the governors, to the senators, to the members of parliament, to the women representatives, to the MCAs, we speak in authority in the name of Jesus that anyone who will try to bring hatred, anyone who will try to plant seeds of division, let their voice come to nothing in the name of Jesus. And we pray for good politicians. We pray for upright politicians who can speak the voice of God into this country. And also we stop the wall from being built. From today, help me as Kenyans, we stop this wall from being built in the name of Jesus. The construction to stop. We stop the construction in the name of Jesus. This morning, I speak against any construction that is going on in the spiritual realm of a wall of hatred. We stop it in the name of Jesus. And we decree, let anybody assigned to build this wall, we tunawafuta hiyo kazi ya kujenga hiyo ukuta katika jina la Yesu. Na tunatangaza ya kwamba wanadamu wale wamewekwa katika miji yetu, katika vijiji vyetu, katika wanawekwa na wanapewa uwezo na wanasiasa ili waweze kujenga hili ukuta. Huu ukuta tumeomba Mungu that they may come back to their right senses. They may come back to their mind in the name of Jesus. Na ukuta huu ubomoke katika jina la Yesu.
ukuta wa chuki, ukuta wa kutu separate, tunatangaza huo ukuta uanguke katika jina la Yesu. Let that wall fall in the mighty name of Jesus. Na tunatangaza ya kwamba we will not be separated. Tumekataa kutenganishwa kama makabila. We love each other as a nation. We love each other as a nation. Na kwa hivyo ukuta wowote ambao unajengwa na ambao ni wa chuki, ambao ni wa tribalism, ambao ni wa hasira, tumeukataa katika jina la Yesu. Number two, the Lord showed me a vision that the two senior politicians that we have in this country, I saw in the night. God took me into a very beautiful room, and in that beautiful room, I saw beautiful chairs that were arranged, and there were two people who are being we were awaiting. I saw people waiting for the two chairs were facing each other. And the other chairs, of course, there were people, the audience that was waiting for the guests of honors, the guests to come. And I was asking myself, who are we waiting for? And then finally, I saw our senior politicians, and that is the President Uhuru Kenyatta. And I also saw the former Prime Minister, Honorable Raila Odinga. And they came and sat on those seats. Both of those seats, because walikuwa naangalia, na wacha nitumie Kiswahili maana inakuwa rahisi, they were facing each other. And right there, I saw them shaking hands. And I saw them speaking very well and saying, let there be peace in this country. And I remember, although there was a lot of tension in the meeting, and there was a lot of misunderstanding, there was like people did not want these two people to sit together, I saw them agreeing and saying, let the country move forward. And I was very happy, and I said, now there is peace in this land. There is peace in Kenya. I come to speak to you, Kenya. As we bring down this wall, then after the wall is broken and brought down, then we, the senior politicians, will speak peace in this country. We'll agree and say, we are brothers, and we are one Kenya, and we are one people. And so I believe, as we are praying and as we are bringing down these walls, there will be a sitting down. And believe me, it is going to happen. There will be a sitting down, and there will be these two senior politicians. They will come to an agreement and say, you know something, our country is bigger than us. Let us move forward, because God loves this country. And I feel when we bring down this wall, peace will prevail in this country. It is not me who's wanted to see these things. It is God who showed me. And so I believe the Lord speaks to his prophets. He speaks to his people. And I believe God has spoken to me, because I love this country. And I believe by his grace, I'm one of the watchmen that stands to pray for this country. I'm one of those that God has called, and I have accepted that call to be a watchman, to stand in the gap because of this country. And I believe, wherever you are as Kenyans, please join me together as we pray. Just a simple prayer as I check out. And I know God is going to hear us, and God is going to do something in this country. Please, wherever you are, believe with me. Thank you, Apostle Alfred, for joining us. Samuel, thank you. Kenya, may Kenya live in the name of Jesus. Thank you so much, Silas. God bless you, Nicholas Mungai. I want us to agree together thank you, Martha. Thank you, Ruth Muya. I want us to agree. And thank you, Mathesh Karioki. Thank you. God bless you. I want us to agree on one thing. The walls are going to come down. Thank you. Amen. Amen. Patricia, that is our prayer. Yes. I want us to agree on that the walls are going to come down. Any wall that is being built in this country that is not of God. Thank you, Esther. Esther Muthoni from U.S. Apostle, God bless you. I see you are doing a good job there in America. And of course, your brother here is also shaking up the city with the gospel. The Lord bless you so much for tuning in and being of support. God bless you so much. I want us to speak a word and make a declaration in this country that any wall that is being constructed that is demonic, let it come crumbling. Let it fall in the name of Jesus. There was a prophet that was sent to speak to the altar, and when he spoke to the altar fell. I want us to pray that the walls of that of evil, of hatred, of division are going to fall. They are not going to be sustained in this country, in the name of Jesus. And we speak by authority and by power that any wall that has been built in this country of division, any wall that has been built, tunafuta kazi watu wale wanajenga hiyo ukuta katika jina la Yesu. Na tunatangaza kwa mamlaka ya Kristo ya kwamba hakutakuwa na ukuta. Kama vile the wall of Berlin, kama mnakumbuka West German, I'm sorry I can't remember exactly the history, but I know in Germany there was a wall ambayo ilikuwa imewatenganisha, and that wall was brought down, and it was a physical wall. Now for me, I'm speaking of a spiritual wall. I speak in authority and power in the name of Jesus. The wall of evil is going to crumble down in Jesus' name. Tunatangaza katika jina la Yesu, ukuta wote ambao umejengwa kinyume na taifa hili ubomoke na uanguke katika jina la Yesu. Tunatangaza mahali popote wanasiasa wanatumika kwa sauti zao kufanya ukuta wa uchuki, ukuta wa ukabila, ukuta wa kutoelewana, tunaukataa katika jina la Yesu. Na tunazungumza taifa hili hatutagawanywa katika jina la Yesu. Hatutagawanywa kwenye misingi ya ukabila katika jina la Yesu. Tunatangazia ukuta huu bomoke. We announce in the name of Jesus, every demonic wall that is being constructed in this country, every demonic wall of separation, of hatred, that is being constructed in this land, let it fall right now in the name of Jesus. Let it crumble in the mighty name of Jesus. Na tunatangaza kwa mamlaka ya Kristo ya kwamba watu wale wamekuwa assigned kujenga ukuta, tumemaliza hiyo kazi yao. We cancel that assignment in the name of Jesus. Anybody that is assigned to build a wall, to bring a separation in this country, tunavunja hiyo wall, tunaivunja katika jina la Yesu. Tunakataa anyone assigned, tunakatana na hiyo assignment katika jina la Yesu. Na tunazungumza kwa mamlaka ya kwamba there will be peace. The senior politicians of this land, they are going to speak peace. They are going even to come together and shake hands, and we are going to decree peace in this land in the name of Jesus. Tumekataa chuki, tumekataa misunderstanding, tumekataa hatred, animosity. Tumetangaza this country will stand. Kenya itasimama katika jina la Yesu. Na tumekubaliana kama wa Kenya katika jina la Yesu, let the presence of God reign in this country. We announce, oh God, let watchmen arise in this country, a spiritual watchman. Let intercessors arise in this country, people who will be able to address the walls that are being built in every country, in every county, in every city, in every town. Kama wewe unaishi na Nairobi, hiyo ukuta ya Nairobi yangusha, ukuta ambao ni ya chuki, ukuta ambao Mungu alinionyesha ya tribal animosity, ukuta ambao ni wa kufanya wa Kenya wachukiane. Kama uko Kisumu, ikatae. Kama wewe uko Mombasa, bomoa hiyo ukuta. Kama uko Nakuru, bomoa hiyo ukuta. Kama uko Eldoret, bomoa hiyo ukuta. Wherever you are, tunabomoa hiyo ukuta katika jina la Yesu. Tunatangaza wajenzi wao tunawavuta kazi, haitajengwa tena. Tumekataa Kenya kugawanywa kwenye misingi ya ukabila katika jina la Yesu. Kama vile ukuta wa Germany ulianguka, hiyo chuki kaondoka, tunabomoa hiyo ukuta katika jina la Yesu. Ukuta wote umejengwa katika ulimwengu wa kiroho utuletee separation, tumeukataa katika jina la Yesu. Na tunatangaza kwa mamlaka ya Kristo ya kwamba we are going to see the senior politicians shaking hands, shaking hands for the sake of this country, shaking hands for this the sake of this country. A shaking of hands is a good thing. It is a gesture of peace. Tunatangaza ya kwamba Kenya is bigger than all of us. Na tunatangaza we will love each other. We will love each other. We will walk together in the mighty name of Jesus. Na tumetangaza kwa mamlaka ya Kristo, it is well with this country. It is well with this country. It is well with our Kenya. It is well with our country in the mighty name of Jesus. Na kuanzia sasa tumetangaza, we tunatangaza hiyo mkutano itafanyika. Na usiwe na moyo ya kutetea tu umetoka pate gani. Let us be tunaita nini, neutral. Don't be a bipartisan. Usingie pande moja. Let us be neutral. Let us be neutral. Tutangaze ya kwamba, whether it is a senior politician who is our president and the former prime minister, wacha washikane mikono wa tuseme hili taifa ni letu. Na waseme kwamba the nation is bigger than us. The nation is bigger than us. Na kwa hivyo tunaomba ya kwamba tutaona that time is coming. That time is coming. That is time is coming. Oh, we cannot live in animosity and hatred. That time is coming, and we call for that meeting in the name of Jesus. Na tunasema it will be well. It will be well. It will be well. We thank you, Jesus, because God, you have heard our prayer and you are able to hear us. Na tumetengaza ukuta wa tribalism. Na ukuta wa hatred umebomoka katika jina la Yesu. Na kwa wa Kenya, nimewatuma maombi hayo. Let us pray. Let us pray to those two prayer points. Na hii ni visions ambazo Mungu alinionyesha. Na ninaamini there is victory. There is victory. There is victory. God bless you so much. God bless you. Thank you, Martha Mwangi. Esther, again, I say thank you, Ruth Muya. The Lord bless you. The Lord bless you. And let us agree together. Moses Wainana, Naina, God bless you. Kate, John. Thank you for joining us. May the Lord uplift us. May you have a good day. And please let's continue praying for this land. And let us continue praying for a united Kenya. A united Kenya. That is our desire. And that is our prayer. May the Lord bless you so much. I'm Pastor Ben Nganga. And God bless you so much. And thank you so much for all those that have joined. And thank you, Honest. Imanyara, God bless you so much. Asante, I appreciate. Thank you so much for joining us. Honest from Nairobi, the Lord bless you so much. Nahashon, God bless you. Vero Kamau, thank you so much. Agnes, Nairobi, stand there as a watchman there and make declarations in Nairobi. Stand with us as we pray and we command every wall to fall. Wangoi, Maura, God bless you. The Lord be with you. And the Lord, thank you so much, my wife. I appreciate your support, Esther. We love you so much also. God bless you and continue doing the good work that you're doing there. Thank you, Faith. We are coming. We are coming to Turi. The Lord bless you. The Lord bless you. Nicholas Mungai, I appreciate all of you. Have a good day. And let us build the nation.